Hello students, in this video I will teach you one grain of rice. I will read out the entire chapter line by line so that it is easier for you to understand. Now you will all take your books out and read along with me. Long ago in India, there lived a Raja who believed he was wise and fair as a Raja should be. So, a character has been introduced. The character is Raja. He thought that he was wise. Wise means he was smart enough to take the right decision. And fair, it means that every human being, all the people living in that town were equal for him. He thought he was like that, just like a Raja should be. The people in his province were rice farmers. The Raja decreed that everyone must give nearly all of their rice to him. I will store the rice safely, the Raja promised the people, so that in time of famine everyone will have rice to eat and no one will go hungry. Each year, the Raja's rice collectors gathered nearly all the people's rice and carried it away to the royal storehouses. So, all the people who were living in that particular area, which was ruled by the Raja, they were all rice farmers. They used to do farming of rice. So, one day the Raja told everybody that you will all give me rice every year and I will store it so that when there is a problem, when there is a natural calamity like a storm coming or something like that, which will destroy all your crops, that time I will give you this rice that I have stored. Everybody agreed to him and then every year the Raja's rice collectors, the people who were in charge of collecting rice, they used to go to the farmer's house and they used to take away all the rice which was extra from them and they used to store it in the royal storehouses. For many years, the rice grew well. The people gave nearly all of their rice to the Raja and the storehouses were always full. So every year, the farming went very good and they had a nice amount of rice that was, you know, being grown in the fields. And every year, the Raja would take nearly all of their rice and he used to store it in the storehouses. So the storehouses had a lot of rice in it. But the people were left with only enough rice to feed themselves. So now the farmers and everybody used to give their rice to be taken to the storehouses. So they had only that amount of rice which could be useful for them for cooking. They did not keep extra rice with them at all. Then one year the rice grew badly and there was famine and hunger. The people had no rice to give to the Raja and they had no rice to eat. So once there was a famine, the crops did not grow properly and the farmers, they were all hungry because they did not have rice for themselves and they did not even have rice to give to the Raja. The Raja's ministers implored him, "Your Highness, let us open the royal storehouses and give the rice to the people as you promised." "No," cried the Raja. "How do I know how long the famine will last? I must have the rice for myself. Promise or no promise, a Raja must not go hungry." So, all the ministers of Raja, they told him that now there is a famine, farmers don't have rice to eat, so we should open the storehouses and give rice to them because you had promised them. But the Raja said no. He did not know how long will this problem stay for and if he gives all the rice right now, then he might have to stay hungry. And whether you promise people or not, but a Raja should never stay hungry. He was being selfish over here. Time went on and the people grew more and more hungry, but the Raja would not give out the rice. Now, everybody was feeling hungry. They did not have rice to eat, but the Raja still did not give rice to the farmers as he had promised. One day, the Raja ordered a feast for himself and his courtiers. Feast means a special gathering because a nice meal is being cooked and courtiers refers to the ministers. So one day the Raja had told that there is going to be a grand feast for me and my courtiers, my ministers. It seemed to him a Raja should feast now and then even when there is a famine. The Raja had this mentality that no matter even if the town is facing a problem like famine, but a Raja should always have a feast. A servant led an elephant from a royal storehouse to the palace carrying two full baskets of rice. So because there was an order for the feast. So one of the servant had gone to the royal storehouse and he was going back to the palace with two full baskets of rice. A village girl named Rani saw that a trickle of rice was falling from one of the baskets. So there was a village girl, her name was Rani, and she saw that the two baskets that the servant was carrying, from one of the baskets the rice grains were falling down. Quickly, she jumped up and walked along beside the elephant, catching the falling rice in her skirt. So, when the girl saw that the rice was falling, she was walking beside the elephant and she had pulled up her skirt. So, the rice was not falling on the ground. It was falling right in her skirt and she was collecting all of it. At the palace, a guard cried, "Halt, thief! Where are you going with that rice?" "I am not a thief," Rani replied. "This rice fell from one of the baskets and I am returning it now to the Raja." So, when the elephant had entered the palace, one of the security guards had seen Rani, that she was collecting all the rice, and he thought that she is a thief. So, he asked her to stop. But Rani said, "I am not a thief. I am collecting all the rice so that I can return it to the Raja." When the Raja heard about Rani's good deed, he asked his ministers to bring her before him. "I wish to reward you for returning what belongs to me," the Raja said to Rani. "Ask me for anything and you shall have it." So now, when Raja heard that Rani did such a nice thing, she was so honest, he called her in front of her and told her that because you have returned what had belonged to me, what was mine, you can ask me for anything and I will give it to you. "Your Highness," said Rani, "I do not deserve any reward at all, but if you wish, you may give me one grain of rice." "Only one grain of rice?" exclaimed the Raja. "Surely you will allow me to reward you more plentifully, as a Raja should." So Rani said that, "I don't deserve anything, but because you are saying so much, I want one grain of rice." But Raja says, "What will you do with only one grain of rice? Because I am a Raja, I will give you some more." "Very well," Rani acquiesced and said, "if it pleases your highness, you may reward me in this way. Today you will give me a single grain of rice, then each day for 30 days you will give me double the rice you gave me the day before. Thus tomorrow you will give me 2 grains of rice, the next day 4 grains of rice, and so on for 30 days. So Rani said that because you are willing to give me more rice than just one grain, so here is a deal. Today you give me one rice and the next day you will double the amount of the rice that you give me." So she explained it to him that today you're giving me one rice, tomorrow you will give me 2 rice, and then further on the third day you'll give me 4. So you will double the amount of rice and this will go on for 30 days. "This seems to be a modest reward," said the Raja, "but you shall have it." Rani was presented with a single grain of rice. The next day, Rani was presented with 2 grains of rice. The following day, Rani was presented with 4 grains of rice. So the Raja had accepted her demand, and on the first day she got 1 rice grain, the next day she got 2 rice grains, and third day she got 4 rice grains. On the 9th day, Rani was presented with 256 grains of rice. She had received in all 511 grains of rice, enough for only a small handful. "This girl is honest but not very clever," thought the Raja. "She would have gained more rice by keeping what fell into her skirt." So now on the 9th day, according to the calculation, she was given 256 grains of rice. She had received in all 511 grains of rice and it was just a small handful. Rice grains are very small. So if you take it in your hand, you think it is very little, but the number is a lot. The Raja thought that she is a nice girl, she is honest, but she is not smart enough. So the Raja thought that if she had not given the rice back which was there in her skirt, she would have had more amount of rice grains than she is demanding from me. On the 12th day, Rani received 248 grains of rice, about 4 hands full. 4 hands full means the grains were supposed to be carried by 4 hands. On the 13th day, she received 4096 grains of rice, enough to fill a bowl. So, 13th day, she had that amount of rice which could fill a bowl. On the 16th day, Rani was presented with a bag containing 32,768 grains of rice. So this much rice was there in a bag. Altogether, she had enough rice for 2 bags. This doubling up adds up to more rice than expected, thought the Raja. But surely her reward won't amount to much more. So the Raja thought that gradually as days are passing, the amount is also increasing. But then he thought that, oh, okay, it's not, you know, too much of the rice grains as I'm thinking. On the 20th day, Rani was presented with 32 bags filled with rice. So because the rice grains were multiplying each day, the quantity was increasing. And on the 20th day, she had gotten 32 full bags of rice. On the 21st day, she received 1,048,576 grains of rice, enough to fill a basket. So on the 21st day, again, according to the calculation, she got rice grains that would fill up a basket. On the 24th day, Rani was presented with 8,388,608 grains of rice, enough to fill 8 baskets which were carried to her by 8 royal horses. So 24th day, there were 8 baskets that she got and they were, you know, carried to her house by 8 horses. On the 27th day, 32 bulls were needed to deliver 64 baskets of rice. So 27th day, she got 64 baskets of rice and these were carried by 32 bulls. The Raja was deeply troubled. One grain of rice has grown very great indeed, he thought. But I shall fulfill the reward to the end as a Raja should. So the Raja was in trouble because a lot of rice was being given to Rani. But he said that it's okay, a Raja should always give the gift that has been asked for, so he has to fulfill the reward. On the 29th day, Rani was presented with the contents of 2 royal storehouses. On the 30th and final day, 256 elephants crossed the province carrying the contents of last 4 royal storehouses, 536,870,912 grains of rice. So finally, till the 30th day, all the rice that was there in the storehouses were presented to Rani. Altogether, Rani had received more than 1 billion grains of rice. So she had gotten 1 billion grains of rice as a reward. The Raja had no more rice to give. "What will you do with this rice?" said the Raja with a sigh. "Now that I have none." So finally, the Raja asks Rani that what will she do with so many rice grains because he has no more grains to give. "I shall give it to all the hungry people," said Rani. "I shall leave a basket of rice for you too, if you promise from now on to take only as much rice as you need." So Rani said that she is going to help the people who are hungry and she is going to give rice to the people. She'll distribute it. And she will also give one basket of rice to the Raja, but only if he promises that he is going to share the rice when it is needed and he is going to fulfill his promises in future. "I promise," said the Raja, and for the rest of his days, the Raja was truly wise and fair as a Raja should be. So the Raja had learnt a lesson that he should not be selfish and he should help poor people. So then Raja had promised that he will always be true. He would be wise and fair, and he turned out to be that way. So Rani had taught a lesson to Raja about how he should be fair and wise and he should not be selfish. Raja had learnt his lessons at the end of the chapter. So that's it. I hope you have understood whatever I've tried to explain. Please read the chapter once again line by line and keep listening to the audio. Further, if there is anything you don't understand, you can always ask me. There are meanings that are given in your books. If apart from that you don't understand, please use your dictionaries. Even after reading the meanings in the dictionary you don't understand, then you will come and ask me. So that's it for the video. Thank you so much for your patience, all of you.